Hello, so we're just going to talk about the type of poem, the genre or the form of the poem, The Clothes by Serote. So you've got some questions for me, Candice.
Yes, ma'am. I've read that it's a free verse, an elegy in a medieval verse, but I didn't understand it. So can you please explain it to me?
Sure. So an elegy forms under, that's a form of poem, under lyrical poetry. So lyrical poetry is usually about the beauty of the sound of a poem. And an elegy was always written when you needed to lament or mourn someone's death. So it's when you're thinking back about someone who meant something to you and you're trying to really give them like a last word, something beautiful to say about them. And in this case, he has to mention the sadness. So it's a lament or mourning song about someone who's died. That's an elegy. And the fact that it's narrative really just means narrative, refers to narration, which is a story or storytelling. And the way that he discusses this is almost like a little story, because he comes home, he sees something, and then he describes what he sees. And then at the end, he makes a conclusion about it, that there is no hope. So in that way, it's a story, because it's got a beginning and a middle and an end. And during the course of the story, the person who's telling the story has actually changed, because he comes home in the morning, which is always full of hope, but by the end of the poem, he's hopeless. He feels that life is futile if the struggle is going to be like this. And then you also asked me about free verse. So free verse is when people write very loose poetry. There's not a definite beat in the rhythm of the poems. And there's maybe very little rhyme. You see that there's only two places here where there's a definite rhyme, the words due and new. And then there's some internal rhyme as well with alliteration. So over here, wrinkled and prime, reddish. And so he's got words that sound similar. Shoes, new, due. But it's not obvious rhyming words. It's sort of very subdued rhyming, and that's what you would call free verse. So does that help?
Yes, ma'am, very much. I understand it much better.
It's a pleasure. The main figure of speech, because alliteration and all those things are parts of figures of speech which make writing colourful. The main figure of speech in this poem is the symbolism, because the clothes are symbolic of the loss of hope. So the main figure of speech is symbolism, and in a way the clothes are also personified, because the clothes almost become like a person, that's, especially when he talks about hanging from a rope. So his clothes become like a person who's been strung up on a rope and has been brought to death. So personification and symbolism are the main figures of speech here. And it's almost like he's decided to not really use a lot of rhyme and stuff, because that might seem too forced. And if you think about it, the scene that he's come upon is quite shocking. So if he had a poem that was very structured, it would almost contradict the fact that it was a really nasty surprise. It's a pleasure.